Welcome. So today I'm going to be showing you how to customize virtual DJ platters. As you can see, this is the one I'm using for now, and this is how it looks like. So how we're going to be doing this, we're going to be editing the virtual DJ. So this original, this is how it looks like, or how it's supposed to look like, but we want it to look like this. So for starters, you need a little bit of some knowledge on image editing, though not a lot of it, either using Photoshop or any other image editing software that you may come across. So let's get started. So for starters, you go to where Virtual DJ keeps its files, and this is in documents, or you can go to my computer or this PC, Windows user, then the user, mine is this, and then look for documents, you'll find Virtual DJ. So now what we'll be going to be working on is the skin, which is found in skins. So you go to skins. As you can see, the skins we have in here, now you choose default, because it's the one we're using right here, the one we're choosing from default. So you go to that folder, default, and look for this. So 2 to 6, because I'm using 2 decks, so the active skin is 2 to 6. And as you can see, whichever you name this is the one that will take that naming, and it's the one that will be active. This was originally the one that is supposed to be used by Virtual DJ. As you can see, if you had to zoom in, this is what appears. So to save us some time, I already cut this out. Let me show you that. I created an empty version of that, just to save us the burden of cutting this out. So all you have to do for now is, I'll share this, all you have to do is just download this and then follow through on the steps. For those that want to add a logo in the middle of that circle, or that need to add like a name, so how we go about that, as I told you, you choose an image editing software. For my case, I've chosen GIMP. I choose GIMP because it's one I'm used to. I've used Photoshop before, but not much of a fan of Photoshop. So we load this that I already created that says empty, then look for this. So you zoom in, this is where you place your name. Now each part of this image has its own function. These small ones, these are actually, these ones move. So as you can see in the Virtual DJ, that's a small bit that I added, this small rotating bit of it. Then if you go back to that, so what we shall do is, again, you use any software that you're comfortable with. All you have to do is just write here. So DJ something. So that is it. Then you center this, and then you can save that. So again, you can actually place an image there. It's not that you have to place only text, you can also use an image, whichever image you have created, but you have to make sure it's right in that circle, that before you enter the white, because when you go into the white, this white is where this movement indicator is placed. So if you had to place an image there, you may not be certain if your platter is moving. So it's better you place it in this space that I've left for you, and make sure the image fits in there. So we save this or we export that as a, make sure whichever software you use, make sure you export it as a PNG. So I'll export this and call it something and export. So do not mind about what GIMP, whatever GIMP is telling us here, because all these are different for each software that you'll be using. It's different for Photoshop, it's different for GIMP. But as long as you place whatever you want in that center and export it as a GIMP, I mean a PNG image, you're good to go. So I've exported it to, I do not need to save. So I've exported it to this. So that is, assuming I'd exported it to a desktop, this would be the image. So what I would have to do is rename this image to 2 to 6 dex. So I would rename this 2 to 6. Then save this. So after saving this as that 2 to 6, I would come back to the folder where virtually J keeps its images, and then I would have to replace this. Since I'm still using this, let me just rename it instead of replacing. This is system. So I get this that I've just created, and I've given it the default virtual DJ name. Then I drop it in there in the default folder. From there, I can go to virtual DJ. Then I'll load that edited. Default edited. So as you can see, DJ something. So that is how you create your own customized platters. In case of any questions, please remember to ask in the comments. Again, use any software that works for you, because a lot of people will claim they do not know how to use GIMP. Others will say they do not know how to use Photoshop. Some actually even use mobile phones. There are apps that will allow you or enable you edit such an image. The image will be shared in the description below. So hope you enjoy this, and success. Thank you.